to start our amazing design logo on Photopea, and today we're concentrating on learning how to use the pen tool. We're going to use a sketch in order for us to follow the sketch along and we know exactly what we're doing. And usually when I come up with ideas, I do sketch my ideas down and then eventually I would put them on computer and then design them. So you'd open a new project, you would pick your size, and then you would create a blank logo canvas in order for you to add your sketch and then start designing. So I'm just going to click and drag my sketch that I've done, and I'm going to link it in the description below. If you want to play along with me, you're welcome to go download it yourself, or you can do your own little sketch as you want. As you can see, the transformation controls are available. So what I want to do is to rotate my sketch so I could hover and find that those back-to-back arrows, and then I can move my sketch around like this so that it is pointing the direction that I want. Then I'm going to click and drag it and make it a nice big size, align it quite nicely on my canvas. And once I'm happy, I'm going to click on correct, and then I know that it's done, and then I'm going to take away my transform controls. My sketch is currently loaded, and it is this one that I didn't rename. So I want to see what I'm going to be designing. Therefore, I'm going to change my opacity and reduce it to like 50, 40 something percent so that I'm able to see what I'm busy doing, but I don't want it to disturb me. I will reduce opacity and then I'm going to lock so that it shows the lock and then it doesn't disturb my design that I'm busy designing. Next, I'm going to go to my pen tool. So pen tool is very versatile and it's very cool, and it will allow us to create and learn how to create curves on Photopea. So I'm going to select my pen tool. It will show on top as a selected tool. Then it will start allowing me to create the shape that I want to create. So the pen tool works with knots. When you click on a knot, you can follow the design with the knots that you're busy clicking on. So you can do a knot by knot, but then it looks not smooth, but we're going to learn that as we carry on. Today we are going to learn the curve and we're going to learn the smooth line of our pen tool. So first I'm going to start on this point and I click on it. As you can see in blue, the first knot is showing. Then I'm going to click on my next point that I want the pen tool to take me to. Because this is nice and straight, I'm just going to click on this point and then it draws a nice straight line. So depending on what color you want your design to be, you could change the stroke and make the stroke the color that you want. So I like gold, so I'm going to stick with gold. And then you could also choose your size of your pixels over here. So I'll stick with 30 and leave it at that. Next, if you want to zoom in, you're going to press Command Plus or Control Plus if you're working on a Windows. I want to move from this point. I'm back on my Move tool, so I'm going to go back to my Pen tool. And I want to move from this blue point to this point. So then I'm going to click on this point, and then it takes me back to that point that I want to have on this side. Next, if I click on this point, it will give me that nice jagged look that I'm looking for that you could create. Next, I want to move from this point to this point of A, and I don't want these other dots to disturb me. Then I'm going to click on my move tool and click on the gray so that the knots are taken away. And then I'm going to go back to my pen tool and then select the point that I want to move from, which is from this point to this other point. Again, I'm going to select my point tool, click on the gray, and then go back to my pen tool. Now, I want to move from this point to this point and create that little curve that you see over there. Then I'm going to click my A over there, and then I'm going to click on this point. As you can see, it creates a straight line. So in order for it to curve the way that I want to curve, then you click and you hold your mouse and then you move your shape so that it starts curving the way that you want it to curve. So at the moment, I'm holding my mouse, nothing special. I'm just curving my A with my mouse. And that's how you create a curve on Photopea. And now I want to move from this point to that point and create that curve again as well. So I'm going to click on the edge of that A point, and I'm gonna hold my mouse and then I'm gonna move it so that it curves the way that I want it to curve, and it curves like that. Then I'm going to hold my Alt key and go back to my point, and I can zoom back in and have a look at my design to see if I'm happy. And I'm gonna click on my move tool, and I'm quite happy with my design. The last thing that I would do is to add my text. I'm going to go to the text tool and click on my type tool, and I'm going to use Alex Brush as the font. Then I'm gonna make my size of my font 150, and I'm gonna stick to gold. Then I'm gonna click on here and then start typing the name of this business that I'm designing for. That is pretty much how you design and using the pen tool on Photopea. So if you want to see how it looks like, you can hide your background by taking away the background and you can see how it looks like. So if you want to convert it to 3D, by all means, you convert it to 3D. Amazing curves. We're creating more and more sophisticated logos using our Photopea. If you want to go and learn different kinds of shapes and text, go watch this next video. I will see you next time.